Hei, det vanskelig å lære norsk, ikke sant? Ja, jo, nei, kanskje, jeg vet ikke. I'm talking like Norwegians with purpose now. Language, it's not just grammar structures, vocabulary, etc. It's the whole system which consists from intonations, mentality. It consists history. Language, it's really exciting thing. And today we are going to find out top 10 fun things about Norwegians talking. My name is Natalie and I invite you to my video. Please subscribe to my channel, let the comments in the section down below. And if you are Norwegian, please forgive me if something is wrong, or write the comments and add some more special things about Norwegians talking. Number one. It's gonna sound very special. Norwegians used to talk both inhaling and exhaling, especially the word ja sound very weird for me. First time I heard it, I was thinking that someone was scared or whatever. It sounds like ja, ja. The important thing to mention about this is that you can use it just in relaxed conversation. For example, with your friends or family, with someone you know, walking on the street, meeting someone you don't know, but the conversation is about anything. It's not official style. Like when you are going to work and your boss asking if you did something, or instead asking to do something, you cannot say like, yeah, yeah, because it's more relaxed, the relaxed way to say it. It sounds like, yeah. Yeah. Number two. Very common way to answer the yes-no questions in Norway is answering by all the answers. It sounds like nei, jo, ja, kanskje, jeg vet ikke. Really, really usual way to answer. It sounds like not so strict, maybe. You cannot say yes, no, vet ikke. They are like dragging sounds and answering in a mild way. But the person with which you speak doesn't know if you answer no, yes, or maybe, or you don't know. Nei, jo, ja, kanskje, jeg vet ikke. Number three. Us endings. This you're gonna hear just while you speak with someone. Mostly on the east of Norway. Actually, but I don't know, maybe someone use it on the west or north. If you are from there, write me in the comments down section below. But generally speaking, I found information that it's Eastern dialect, slang, mostly slang, not dialect. It sounds like dette interessant, ass. Ass. It sounds more youthful in a way, it's age related more, but more and more people older use it as well. Kind of cool way to say things. It's coming from word also, which means therefore, so, thus, but it differs meaning, of course. Dette interessant, ass. Number four. For me, it was really special and unusual. Norwegians used to answer questions which does not require answer yes or no. No. First, before answering it. For example, hva syns du? Nei, det likte jeg. Hva liker du? Nei, jeg liker å løpe og sykle. For example. So, questions which do not require answer yes or no or whatever, they begin to answering with no. Some people use it more, some people use it less, but it's a very common way to answer questions, just to sound flytende. Number five, the word spennende, which means exciting or excited. I've noticed that Norwegians overuse it, but the meaning is lost, the meaning is dead. For me, excited means like something which raise up your heart beating.
You feel excited, your eyes big, you are happy, you are doing something new for you, like completely new or unusual.
But Norwegians can answer for very usual questions. No, det var spennende. Det var spennende, ja. In a conversation. For example, skal vi spise indisk I kveld? Ja, det var spennende. Or, jeg løp en ny rute I går. Det var spennende. Like, the meaning of word excited is not so strong. Det var spennende. Number 6. The way Norwegians talking with each other, especially people which know each other, friends, family, or even you don't know, but you meet in the forest, because Norwegians in the forest are much more friendly and used to talk or say hello more than on the streets in the town. So the way they are talking and they're using a lot of sounds, One time I was experiencing two people talking, and it was like around 30 seconds or even more, just looking at each other, and feels like they really understood each other. Number 7. The ways to react on stressful situations. This was really shocking for me, and I'm not sure if I can say it, but
I will anyway.
Last year on the TV, NRK.no, which I recommend you to watch, I've seen the episode from one couple in Norway, which had a house in Spain, and the law in Spain says that everyone has the right to have their own property or the place to live, let's say. And these Norwegians lost their house because someone just stole it or came to live in it. And they were not like panicking or angry or whatever. They just like, ja, det veldig trist, ja. Det var veldig dårlig gjort. I mean, like if something like that would happen to me, I would be angry or screaming or I would show my emotions, but Norwegians are so calm and capable of controlling their own emotions that they react very calm even in so stressful situations, because they know that everything gonna be fine. Number 8. Overusing word eller. Eller means or, and I would say it like, liker du epler eller bananer? Liker du å løpe eller å sykle? But Norwegians use it in addition in muntlig språk, in conversations, just to hear answer yes or no, or just not without meaning to hear any answers. Like, skal vi ha pizza eller? In the meaning like, we are going to have pizza, but eller it's just like, to push the person you ask to answer, or like bekrefte, to confirm. Or skal vi dra eller? When you are sitting, you're visiting someone and you already know that you have to go home, and you say skal vi dra eller? And it means like, yeah, we have to go, but not in a rude way, not in a strict way, and like, yes, we have to get up and go now, but like to push the person you came with to get up and dress and to say goodbye and just go. Skal vi dra eller? Number 9. Using of small word da in the end of sentences. Now, as you know, because you learn Norwegian, that you can use da og når when you refer to the time. Da only when you use for the past, and når also. If you want, I can make a video about it. For example, da in the meaning of past time. Da jeg var liten, fikk jeg mye gratis. When I was a kid, I've got a lot of free things when I was a kid in the past time. But Norwegians use da, små ord, like to connect sentences. For example, hva skal vi spise da? Det var et fint maleri da. Hva skal vi gjøre da? Ja vel da. Now, I have to say that not everyone uses it, and it's more also slang. It's getting more and more popular, but mostly maybe youth use it. But anyway, I've heard it quite a lot. Number 10. Using ikke sant? Now, it sounds like a question and you can use it in two ways. When you're asking someone and you're waiting for confirmation, or you can answer the statement or a question. For example, when you are asking, han gift, ikke sant? Even if you could ask, han gift? Han gift? And you say, ja, han gift. Eller nei, han ikke det. Or for example, 2020 et spesielt år. Ja, ikke sant? You are like confirming that yes, it was really special year. Ikke sant is very commonly used, so please use it and use it in the right way. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please let me know in the comments in the section down below if you enjoyed it, if you've heard yourself all these things what I mentioned, which I'm noticing every day or at least often. I wait for your subscriptions and your desires for my next videos. Thank you so much and see you next time. Hadi!